Guys, it's Hi, and I'd like to share with you guys a new tool that I recently acquired, and I think some of you will be interested in. This is the half-inch split beam torque wrench from Olsa Tools. If you're like me, you're likely more familiar with the micrometer click type torque wrenches. Split beam torque wrenches, on the other hand, have a spring that's always under the same tension and is more dependent on something similar to a lever and catch mechanism. A big advantage of the split beam design is that because the spring is always under the same tension, users don't have to worry about it deforming and contributing to inaccurate readings as possible with the micrometer type torque wrenches. With a micrometer torque wrench, the proper procedure for storage is to release the tension of the spring by lowering the torque setting to its minimum. That way the spring doesn't form to its compressed size while it's not being used and sitting in storage. With the split beam design, there's no such thing. It can be left at whatever torque setting for however long and the spring will not deform. Another big advantage of the split beam design is the ease of adjustment. With the micrometer design, you typically twist the handle up and down, working your way through the torque range. With the split beam, you're able to move through the range almost effortlessly. This Olsa Tools split beam torque wrench has a working range of 50 to 250 foot-pound, and you can get from one end of the range to the other in a few seconds. To use this torque wrench, you first flip open the safety lock. From here, you turn the knob up and down to get to the desired setting. When you've achieved the desired setting, just close the safety lock and you're good to go. This design is very quick and easy to use. Here's a look at the torque wrench in action. I've set the torque wrench to my desired torque setting, and all there's to do is to tighten these lug nuts down. This one will emit an audible click when the desired torque is achieved. After owning this torque wrench for a few weeks, I would say that I like it a lot, but I have noticed two drawbacks. First, the torque display window only shows increments of 5. This is fine if everything that you torque down requires a torque setting that ends in 5 or 0, and because all the numbers and lines are so close to each other, whenever you need one of those in-between numbers, it becomes a guessing game as to where to set the torque wrench at. The second drawback is that the torque wrench only measures when used on 4 clockwise rotating fasteners. There's no reverse. This is something inherently attributed to the split beam design, so it's not a knock on Olsa Tools. Overall, I would give this tool a thumbs up and a recommendation. It seems to be of high quality and functions really well. Not to mention that Olsa Tools also offers a lifetime warranty on this thing, so if it were to ever become defective, they'll take care of it. If you're interested in trying this tool out for yourself, check out the links in the description below. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more content. Thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one.